us cross to the German border, and we wound up in Munich, and from there we went to Landsberg, where my oldest sister was already there, and we lived with a German family I was there with my oldest sister. One of my sisters went with Aliyah Bet to Israel, and myself and my sister Paula, we went to the English sector of Germany, where the British were giving out 1,500 certificates to people in their sector to go to Israel. So we went with Ali Aleph, an assumed name. We all used names, most of the people used names of people that were killed in Bergen-Belsen, because that's where we were. And we went to Israel, and that was 48, before the war started, before the independence war in Israel. And I lived there for 10 years. My mom and dad came a little later in the year. And so I lived through another war in Israel, the War of Independence. I went to to school there, then I went to the army, and 10 years later I came to the United States. I said, I don't want to get settled until I see how other people live. And everybody was talking about America. America is the land of opportunity. So I came and I stayed. I met my husband, David Levine. And I stayed in the States. I had three children. My husband went to night school and he became an engineer. And he worked for General Electric for 15 years. And then he worked on his own. And he had his own company. And we lived ever happy ever after until he died in 2005.
No. He died in 2005?
Yes.
No. Died in 2015.
2015, 3 years ago. And now my youngest daughter is taking care of me. And my oldest daughter lives in New Jersey, but she comes and helps out when my youngest is a little cranky already, and so Gary comes and helps out.
Ruth, we're here in Ohio and have the opportunity to meet you and interview you and photograph you, but we've also had this opportunity to photograph these four beautiful rings that were given to you by your father.
About the rings. My father knew a lot of people, and a lot of people knew my father. So one day, while we were already in the small ghetto, they were already in the small ghetto, somebody, after they liquidated the small ghetto, and they took everybody to Hasad and the other two labor camps that were in Częstochowa, someone came, a jeweler, came to me and he said, I buried a can of goods from my store in a place. You can get it, I'll split it with you. So my father said, where is it? And at first he didn't tell him because he was afraid that my father is going to steal from him, you know. Take it and not tell him that he couldn't get it. But eventually he told him exactly where to go and where that treasure was buried. And my father bribed the Polish policemen that they used to take him to work and back. him to the place, and he dug up the treasure, and it was really a treasure. There was a lot of jewelry in it, and my father, of course, had to bribe the policeman. He had to give him some money, and he brought the can, I think, to the Hasak, and the guy came, and they split it 50-50. And my father picked out rings for all of us, for the four girls and my mom. And he gave us each a ring and said, you keep it, you hide it from the Germans, and you keep it. And when you're in dire need, and it's between your life and death, you give them the ring, maybe that will save. So we all had the ring, and we were, after we still had the rings, and I wore my ring for a long time until it got too small for me, and I gave it to my daughter Gay. And she had the ring, and she wore it for a long time, and my sisters too, and my mom. And when my mom came to visit the last time to the States, she gave me the ring. And she said, you keep it. So I had my ring and my mom's ring. And then my sister migrated to Australia. And the first time I visited Australia, she gave me the ring. And after my sister Paula died at 38, she died in Germany, and of course I went to the funeral, and her husband gave me the ring. So I had four rings. And I don't know what happened to the ring that my oldest sister had. She probably gave it to her daughter, I don't know. That's the story of the rings. We did, nobody, none of us needed to use it for our life, to save our life, but we kept them.
It's a wonderful gift.
Yeah, it was one of the gifts that my father gave us. And we all even in the on Hasak, there were some Polish people that worked on Hasak also. And they were punished for something and they had to work. So they would bring stuff and you could buy stuff from them in exchange for some jewelry or money or dollars that every Jew would keep. You never keep the currency of Poland or złoty because it didn't have much value. But gold was very valuable, and everybody wanted the gold, so they brought stuff. And we, till the end, we had enough money to buy stuff, not to have to eat the allotted bread and soup that they handed out. But there were a lot of people that did. So we used to give the bread and the coupons for the bread and for the soup to more needy people.